Today we're going to upgrade this tool post grinder with a free treadmill I got off Facebook Marketplace. It had everything I needed, a 3-horse motor and a controller, and a lot of junk that I didn't need. The motor was very easy to harvest, along with the controller as well. However, there was a bit of research on how to put this all together, but we'll get to that in a minute. The first step was to take this 60 to 70 year old motor off the grinder and to figure out how we're going to lay out the new motor onto it. And of course, along the way, I had a few challenges, but I got them relatively ironed out quick. A little bit bittersweet, this had a keyed shaft on it, but it was an 18 millimeter shaft. And this is probably a little bit better than some of the threaded versions because I can run it in either direction. However, finding an 18 millimeter pulley presented a bit of a problem, but I had a bit of luck. Now let's take a quick look at the motor controller that I'm holding here. This motor controller presented a bit of a problem for me, but I did some research and I'll put the link where I found it. My first plan of attack was to figure out which board I have. And it's clearly shown here, it's an alt6330. Now I just typed in online alt3600 and lucky for me, I came up with a guy in a forum back in 2016. He had a problem with one of these and he explained it absolutely specific for what I needed to do this board. And it turns out it's super simple. By cutting into these wires here, all I have to do is cross the orange and the black. That's going to give it a qualification and send power to a relay. By touching the blue wire to the yellow wire, it's basically going to act like a signal to go up 1 kilometer an hour. So it'll be a momentary push on and then off, and it'll send a signal then to go slower. Basically what you're going to do is you're going to do the opposite. You're going to touch that green wire to the blue wire. And now that I've bench tested everything, I'm a little bit more comfortable with drilling holes into the machine. This is a retrofit on top of a retrofit, but still, it's never good to drill a hole in the wrong spot and have to fix it later. Now, the mag drill wasn't absolutely necessary, of course, but I just kind of had it sitting down at my feet and it was readily available and it worked out quite well. One problem that I did have that was related directly to the machine was that I actually had to put a bit more tension on the belt and put a longer belt on. So you'll probably see this pulley on and off a few times as I kind of experimented with how far out it should be. Now, I ran down to E-Cole, one of our local electrical suppliers, and picked up this power box. This power box worked out quite well, and it was actually for a reasonable price. I think it was about $30 Canadian. And I already had a bolt that was going to fit onto it, and this was going to hold the box on right in the right location. The only sacrifice was I had to give up a light, but I didn't really ever use that light very often anyways. Now, I'm basically going to get rid of all of the switches that are down below. Well, I'm not going to get rid of them. I'm just not going to use them anymore. And I'm going to install this circuit board in here with some wires going straight to the circuit board. And then I'm basically going to fit all the bits and bytes when I bench tested it and add it out. Now, the e-stop's really important because remember that orange and black wire that I had? This is what's going to connect and unconnect that circuit. I probably should have added a main power switch to this machine, but generally this machine is unplugged when it's not in use. And I did put a light that was handy to tell that if I had forgotten to unplug it, there'd be an orange light on top to tell me. The next step was to install the up and down switches. Now, remember it's just a momentary push of the button to send the signal up or down. So I'm going to install 2 switches that are momentary push button switches. I think I picked these up for about $10 at Princess Auto. Or I guess the American version would be Harbor Freight. Now, not all treadmill motor controllers are created equal. Some are going to have a rheostat on them to send a signal up and down related to voltage. And I'll put some links down below for some other places you can find information. Now, for one of the problems that I had. Originally, I had cut a pulley and attached it on, but I had a bit of a vibration. At first, I thought it was the counterweight, but then later I found out that it wasn't enough tension on the actual motor to stop the vibration. You see, I had a spring underneath it originally, and the motor just seemed to hop up and down. Now for the fun part of the whole build is making the speed sensor for the RPM gauge. On the back of the machine where I took the previous pulley off, I have to make a kind of a sensor that looks like a mushroom that's going to house the magnet. This has to be relatively tight, but it doesn't have to withhold any torque at all. After the hole was bored, I had to take it over to the milling machine and cut a little pocket for the sensor. And unfortunately, I didn't have a 1/2-inch end mill, so I had to make do with a 5/8 end mill. It's like my dad always said, it's
not about the mistakes you make, it's about how you fix your mistakes. And I think we'll hide that a little bit later with some epoxy. Now our next step is going to be to put a set screw in it to hold the sensor on the back of the shaft. Now remember, this isn't going to have any torque whatsoever to it. It's just going to have a little tiny magnet inserted in there, and it's going to go by a sensor. The speed it moves past the sensor is going to tell how many rotations a minute there are. And since I didn't spend a whole lot of time making this part, I figured I was going to risk it, and I was going to send that 1/4 inch by 20 through there, power tapping it, and hope I didn't break it. And it did work out this time. But I don't generally recommend doing it all the way through, just maybe the first 3 threads usually. Now let's jump down into the woodworking room and grab some of that 2-part epoxy. Now I just put a little bit of red dye in there just for fun, because I got to dress up my mistake a little bit, right? And the end result was it turned out quite well. The 2-part epoxy was a little bit of a steep investment originally to get into, but it's actually been pretty useful on a lot of projects that I've had. And I mean, it doesn't look too bad either. Now, this sensor is going to run by at about 3 millimeters to about 1 millimeter. Now, this doesn't actually count the number of rotations in a minute. It just counts the speed that it's going to travel past it, and it calculates your RPM for you. And it seems to be pretty close to the RPM once I got it up and running. Let's put it all together and see how this all works out. Hey, and remember as always, hit the like button down below. It's the cost of admission, and it's what drives me to make better and better videos, and it pushes up the algorithm so that people like you can see this video as well. Now that we got it all together and running, let's throw an end mill in the weld and sharpener and see how it all worked out.